फिजिक्स क्लास ओके आई थिंक द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ फिजिक्स दैट मीन्स दिस वन हीट एंड टेम्परेचर सो दिस चैप्टर द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड ओके सो टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज ओके सो द फर्स्ट वन सो द करेक्ट ऑप्शन व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग विल ऑकर इफ यू टच ए कोल्ड ऑब्जेक्ट सो देयर आर फोर ऑप्शंस वन इज हीट फ्रॉम द कोल्ड ऑब्जेक्ट विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड टू योर बॉडी सेकेंड वन इज बी इज हीट फ्रॉम योर बॉडी विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड टू द ऑब्जेक्ट कूल एयर विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम द ऑब्जेक्ट टू योर बॉडी एंड नन ऑफ अबव सो लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट समथिंग ओके व्हेनेवर देयर आर टू बॉडीज वन इज सपोज cold bodies and another one suppose hot okay hot body whenever these two body connect with each other then the temperature from the higher difference the higher temperature of the higher body will be convert to the lower body okay that means energy that means actually heat is what it is a heat is one of the type of energy okay and energy is transformed from one all of you know that I think energy neither be created nor be destroyed. It can transform from one state to another state. Okay, and in case of this, whenever you connect a hot body and a cold body, then temperature from the hot body move towards the cold one. Okay, so in this case, they are asking that if you touch a cold object, that means your temperature must be hotter than the cold object. They are asking that you touch a cold body. Clear? That means the temperature of that body is lower than your lower than the temperature of you. Okay? So that means heat from cold. The first one. Look at the first one. Heat from the cold object will be transferred to your body. No, impossible. Second one. Heat from your body will be transferred to the object. That means from hot body to cold body. Question number C, cool air will be transferred from, there is not, again, D, none of option. That means the answer one is B. So question number one, that is B, let us write. If you touch a cold object, if you touch a cold object, so answer B is correct here. Heat from your body will be transferred to the object. Okay. This type of question will ask in your periodic exam. Okay, so now come to the question number two. Question number two is asking that which state, which one is correct when in terms of expanding. Okay, so which of the following is correct order of the states of matter according to their ability to expand? Okay, states of matter according to their ability of expand. Expand means. Remember one thing, when the intermolecular force of attraction between the particles are strong, then there is a less tendency to expand. Okay, whenever intermolecular force of attraction are strong, that means there is a lower tendency to expand. That means in case of solid, the intermolecular force of attraction is highest. Intermolecular means the attraction in between the molecules, okay? Intermolecular force of attraction is higher. Then after solid, it is liquid. Okay, and then gas or gaseous. Okay, that means in case of solid, the intermolecular force of attractions are very high. Therefore, the particles are stick together. They are and form a solid shape. In case of liquid, the intermolecular force of attraction in between the part among the particles is less than solid. Okay, that is why you can push your hand through water, okay? But in case of, but you cannot push your hand through a solid, because in terms of force of attraction, this one is solid. You cannot push this one, okay? Like this. But in case of liquid, your hand will pass through, but you feel the liquid. But in case of gaseous, again intermolecular force of attraction very low, okay, very weak. That means, so that means suppose this is air, so I just push my hand, but I feel nothing, okay. So that means whenever the intermolecular force of attraction is smaller, then there is a higher tendency to expand, okay, clear. That means this one is the first one, gas. Than liquid, the solid, okay. And what is this actually? The tendency of expand, okay. Expansion. So, this one, which of the following is the correct order of these states of matter according to their ability to expand? So, B, gas, liquid, or solid, okay. That means you just write number two, the correct order. The correct order of these states of matter according to their ability to expand. So B one, this one, gas, liquid, and solid. Okay. So now question number three. So I think all of you know this formula. Which of the following is the correct? So both A and B, I think. Come to the page number. This one. You just look at the page number 65. So Fahrenheit, whenever you convert Fahrenheit to centigrade, so F equal to C into 9 by 5 plus 32, okay. Again, whenever you convert Fahrenheit to Celsius, then F minus 32 into 5 by 9. So both are Celsius, both are correct, okay. Question number 3, both are correct. Question number 4, which of the following thermometer should be used for, say, it is a clinical thermometer, all of you know. And now question number 5, 10 degree centigrade is equal to, now question is 10 degree centigrade, okay. Now whenever you convert centigrade to Fahrenheit, which one, F minus centigrade to Fahrenheit, then Fahrenheit is what? The formula is, you know, the F is equal to C into 9 by 5, plus 32, that is the formula. So whenever you convert centigrade to Fahrenheit, so this one is, we have F equal to C into 9 by 5 plus 32. So in case C is, the velocity is 10, okay, so 9 by 5 plus 32. So let's divide, so it's 2 to range 18 plus 32, that means F equal to 50, okay. So therefore, Fahrenheit equal, option is given, this one, 50 degree Fahrenheit. So answer is, let's write, the answer is 50 degree Fahrenheit, okay. So in my next video, I will discuss the true and false.